Good morning. Welcome to the studio. I'm Lindy Witten. Today I'm just going to be looking at a Canson Mi Tients paper that I haven't used before. It's called Mi Tients SMOOTH. It feels quite smooth, but it's got a bit of grit on it as well. So it's the baby cousin of the Mi Tients textured, which is a very textured sanded paper. Holds layers and layers of colour without the dust coming off, and I love using it. It's one of my go-to papers. So I'm just going to give this one a try because it's in a favourite colour of mine, but they've now made it in the smooth in my local art shop. They didn't have the texture, they had the smooth, so I'm going to work on that and see how many layers of pastel that will hold. I'm going to be also demonstrating the painting using this reference, which is down the Tasman Peninsula. It's got a nice lot of distant hills to give me some perspective, and it's got a very long beach here with ripples of water showing the reflections of the head vein. And down here, probably can't see it very well on the video, it's just lost that for you, haven't I? It's nice red samphire. So here we go, let's pop that up there and let's get going. Now I'm going to put in the sky first, and it's a very easy sky. It's just very straight blues. I'm putting a bluey green in there as well, and I'm going to put in some light colours down the bottom, just swathing across with the flat of my pastel, putting all the colour in, just a few different colours of blue in there. And I'm going to go back and pop in a little tiny bit of very pale yellow. Just going to find a pale yellow here. Just going to give that there. I like to have a little bit of the light on the horizon there. Just going to pop back in with the blues again. I get quite light near the horizon. And then I'm just going to use the side of my finger, not to push it right, just to give it a little bit of a skim across the surface there, just to blend in a little. I might make the top of the sky a little bit bluer. Let's see, a little bit bluer up the top there. So I'm just running over it again with some deeper pastel colours, and then I'll be going back in with the lighter over the top of that. And then just again skimming across with the side of my finger. So put the sky in, and it's holding those layers quite well. It takes no effort at all to put it into the paper, and I'm not sure how I feel about that at this point, but we'll see later on. Now I'm going to pop in the distant hills here. So just the general shapes there, and just the side of my pastel again, pulling the colours down. At the front there's a much darker hill, so I'm just coming along with the darker pastel and putting in the darker hill silhouettes with some rough bits up the top with just the tip of my pastel to indicate the trees. I'm not worrying too much about that edge because it's going to be behind. And there you go. And I'm letting some of this softer coloured base show through because it's going to help me with the unifying the painting. I'm just going to go in with a few other blues there, just to some green blues, keeping it nice and cool back there in the distance. Maybe a little bit of a purpley colour over the top as well in places. That'll help to blend in with the background colour on this particular paper. So getting a little bit of sense of dimensionality in there, and I'm also going to pop in a sort of a few touches of yellows over the top of those blues there for some paddocks there in those more foreground hills. Okay, I might go back in again with another blue there. Just to get it the way I want it. And to re-establish some of those little tree highlights there. So we can be sure that we know that there are, that's a tree, a hill full of trees. Okay, so there's my background. I've got it receding, I've got a bit of depth in it. I now want to put in the thin line of pale water going across the horizon. And I'm just going to use a straight edge for that because I want that to be very straight. Pop it there. I've got a very sharp pastel here. I'll just take it and drag it right away across there. And there I've got my distant sparkly water without too much trouble at all. Now I'm going to put in the rest of the colours of the water. The headland's coming up here, so I won't have to put water behind there because it's a big mass of trees with hardly any water showing through at all, but I want to put the water colours in, and I've established already in my mind and on the paper that that's sort of going to be where it comes down to the beach here, about that level. So I'm just going to put in a little bit of colour there just to remind me that's where I want to come to. Then I'm just going to put some layers of colour, different blues for the water back in here. I'm just running them across, different blues, some darker greens. It's very green back here. I'll have to go and re-establish that line because I've just got green on it. Here we go. And it is, the paper is holding the pastel quite well, so I'm pleased about that. I was concerned that it might not. Just put in a couple of deeper blues back here. And there's a lot of white caps on the water this day. There was a bit of wind kicking up, the breeze coming in. And it's actually made for quite a lot of white caps there. If I'd used white paper, all those little sparkles showing through would have given me my white caps, but I didn't choose to use that. I actually want to go back into the sky. It's a bit too dull for me. It's a sunny day, so I'm going back in with a more cerulean sky blue there. I think that's going to help me get the look I'm after when I come down to the reflections. So I've made the sky a little bit bluer. Summery blue there. I will put in that the little sort of light coloured yellow across the edge there, and I'm just going to go back in with that blue over the top, and then a lighter blue just as we come down into that. So just put in the lighter blue colour as we come down into the closer to the hills, to the horizon, back in with that. And that sky is coming up quite nicely now. It just looks a more summery sky. And now I'm just using the side of it, not my finger, the side of the pastel to blend that in. And it gives it a nice little sparkle. Let's take that. Okay, so we've got sky hills and we've got the water. I'm going to put a couple of dabs of the white caps on there in a very pale blue, not a white, so out here it'll just be a couple. Just a few hints of the white caps, and as you're coming closer, they're more pronounced. So just a little bit more here as it comes around the rocks and across there. Now I'm not using white, I'm using a pale blue, so I can go back in later with a very bright white and just beef that up a little bit. I think I need to just put a bit more blue through the back of there. Okay, right, happy with the sea. Now I want to do the headland there. So I'm just going to go in with some ochre-y sort of colours just to start establishing that. So it's just pull it down in strokes in the direction that the rocks would be going, and that's just going to come all the way around there. And then I want some lighter colours as well going in there, and I'll go in for some lighter ones of those sienna sort of colours, and I'll have some darker ones as well, but I also want some very light more yellowy colours. Let's take that one and pull. That's not quite what I'm after. Some of these colours, sort of where the sun's hitting the edges of some of those rocks. And this is the harder pastel. The pastel is staying nicely on that paper, very happy with that. And I might go for a couple of lighter spots around here on the headland and on this little outcrop of rocks here, just to give it the sense that the sun is catching some of those rocks. And then I need to go around the base of it with a really dark colour. So I'll just start off with something like this, and the rocks have come out like this, and you can get in some shadows up behind them. Get all the base along here of the, it's coming out a little bit darker into the sand there, and quite dark in behind some of these rocks there. And where it's sort of shadowed under the trees as it goes back into the tree line there. So we've got a quick headland in there. I need to put the trees in now. So I'm just going to start by laying in a couple of strokes of tree trunk. So just establish those with the sharp side of the pastel. And a couple out here. And I can go back with a pencil later on and fix those up. But right now I just want to put in the colours of the, and I'm starting off with a dark blue, just side of the pastel, giving it a general shape. I want to go right up into the sky there and just give those rounded tops of the gum trees, and then a few down here. On the edge there. So that's putting in the mass of the in the dark blues, but I also need to put in some greens, and I'm going to put in some purple. So it's quite a bright purple, but I think I'll add in a little bit of that too, just for a bit of colour. And I'm going to make it quite dark down around the edge there. Some greens. There's a few sky holes there. And a bit of suggestion of detail around the edges of those trees there. I'm going to put these trees out here. I'm going to give a little bit of a lighter treatment in a minute to show whether they're catching the light. These ones back in this part of it are fairly dark, although there will be some light coming in and dark along the edge. So I've just established in the mass of trees there. I want to go in and put a little bit of lighter greens around the edges now. I'm going to use this sort of yellow green. And there we have the bits that are catching the light. And it's Australia, so they're gold greens and blue greens rather than vivid greens of Europe and the evergreen trees. So I'm catching the sun with that. I could even put it in slightly lighter, a couple of lighter touches there around some of those, just just a few. Not too much, just a suggestion of lighter areas around some of the catching on some of those trees. Okay, so that's my area there, but I am going to put in some more shadowed areas on the rocks there where the trees are showing, throwing a few shadows there. Okay. Right. Now I need to get in the beachy bit here. And all this area down here is a red samphire, so I'm actually going to start by laying in a bit of green there, just an under touch of green, even though most of it is going to be red. And then I'll go over that with a dark red, because it's quite deep and dark, that samphire, so we'll go over it with a darker red. Just gently laying it in there. So just dragging across the paper, not pushing it all the way in, and it's giving me that look of samphire. In amongst that, there'll be some deeper purpley sort of colours, and I'll just lay a few of those in. And they're going to be some of these more brownie reds amongst it as well. We'll put those in. And we mustn't forget the green, which I want to re-establish a little bit. Some of those bits of dark green. We'll go back in there and pop in a couple of, just a little bit of a redder red, a brighter red, just a few touches of it. There. This is a good undercolour for the sand. I'm going to put the sand in, but I need to also put in the reflections of the cliff on the sand, so I'm going to go for some sandy sort of colour. I'm just trying that out there. Not quite right. That's a bit better. We might start off with this. And so the sand's coming across in layers, in sort of bands. And in between the bands are going to be the darker colours. So just laying in the sandy colours. It's darker sand out here where I'm putting this in, but as we come in here it becomes a bit lighter, although there are some... it's quite tricky to get sand colour sometimes. It's too warm, but I think what I might do is to do a bit of layering. So I think I'll start off with this, which is lighter, for some of the lighter sand colour. Where the sunlight's catching it here in between the ripples, and where it's drier you get this lighter colour, and that's going to come all the way around the samphire. And up through here, I might make that darker in a minute, quite light around here. And then we'll start catching a couple of little streaks of the lighter one there, but quite dark some of the rest of the sand there. And I think I might go with that. I can go back in and, you know, put in some... That's far too yellow, so just go back where I was. I was quite happy with that colour, so let's just leave that there. And now I need to put in the sky colour reflecting down into the water there, so I'll just pull out some of these and we'll start up here and reflect some of the sky colour down. Some quite have lovely ripples of sky reflected in there. Even a little spot of water in amongst this sandfire here. The wet sand reflecting the sky there. A few patches around here. And then I want some of the colours from up there, the deep darks of the trees, to be reflected across there too, in the wet ripples. So it's little thin ripples of. Reinforce the sand in between it. So there's the And there we have the idea of the sand. Again, the paper is really holding those layers really well. I'm very, very surprised at how well it's holding it, but really pleased too. So over here, I just want to put a bit more of the water in. And just whip that up a little bit. And just making it a little bit darker around here in the sand, where it's quite wet and we're getting quite a bit of the reflections coming down into it. I'll just give my finger a little rub across there, just to make it a little bit smoother, a little more like reflections, and then coming back with the dry sand, which doesn't have that reflective quality in it. Okay, and along the edge here of the sandfire, I'll just sharpen it up a bit with a little bit darker colours. And a few warmer, darker colours in here for the wet sand where it goes out there. Okay, up in here I'm just going to tidy up those. Tree branches. Maybe put a couple more in there. And then down here I might have in, coming across here, just some branches coming in from the side to give it another sense of depth. And the pastel pencil works well on the over that paper as well. I'm going to have another one coming in here.
then I might give them a little touch of something, colour on them as well. Just to, what they need is a little bit of grey or purple. Purple, maybe a tiny bit of silvery purple on them. In the last little bits, I want a little bit more of that sky colour in amongst. And a bit of sand in amongst there, so I'm just going to pop in a little bit of. One thing about this, it makes blending very easy, and if you don't want blending, then you might have to use a bit of fixative on it, because just putting it over the red really blends it in. I didn't want it blended in there. So I'm just sprayed a little bit of fixative on there. I'm going to go back in and just give that a little bit of a oomph there. Actually, little patches of some brighter reds amongst those darker reds around there, just to give it a bit of variety. And I'm also going to go back in and put in a bit of the sand colour there, just restate the sand coming around there, through that, a little sand coming in there. Just a few more different colours in the sand there. Already. I also want to, I don't quite like this area here, so I've got some trees coming there. I think I'm going to put a bit of greenery on that tree is what I'm going to do. So I'm going to put in some green coming down like that, and actually some deeper ones as well. I want to get a bit of deepness. Colour in there, maybe coming up through there too. So I've got some shrubbery around there. I want to put a little bit of sunlight on that side of the bushes. So let's put a little bit of the sunlight there. Beef up the sunlight on those trees too. Putting in some more branches there. And a little bit of darker green in amongst that. Maybe I'm just going to put a little bit there as well. Just to make that the, where the, I was actually standing up on the road taking that photo, so we'll make that the bank going, the shrubbery in front of the road. And catch it a little bit more with something a little bit brighter. And also put in some more purples in behind there. There we go. I'd actually like this to be a little bit darker, so I'm going to go back in with a darker sort of. And maybe another one, I'll make those ones a little bit darker, I think that would work better too. And stick a couple more up through there. Maybe I'll just darken that up a little bit there too. Just to give it a bit more contrast. So here we have a small painting using the Canson Mi Tients smooth paper. A little bit of grit on it, not very much. And what I found was it holds the pastel quite well. It allows you to blend very well because it's quite smooth, and when you put an extra layer of pastel on top, it really does help blend the pastel below. So if you don't want it to be too blended, you might need to use fixative in between the layers. Did I like it? Yes, I think I'll probably use it again and maybe use it for those paintings that I want to have a more blended, smoother look. So a successful little trial with that. Hope you enjoyed painting with me today in the studio, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.